I'm Olivia Bean. This Presley came through Atlanta in 1962 to film It Happened at the World's Fair. And of course, it was a very big deal in town. So I took that topic, and I have Elvis standing in a line drawing of the town of Kalama downtown. And then all these things are little clues about his visit. There's the room he stayed in at what is now Motel 6.
Uh-huh.
But at the time, I think it was the Collier River Inn. This restaurant, of course, is still there.
Mm-hmm.
And I was shown the booth that he was in, reading the paper, because he spent the night. And
yeah.
So, yeah, well, anyway.
Yeah.
It was a big deal. And I, at first, you know, basically, this is what he wore.
Okay.
It was kind of
so that's
like,
him being, like, mobbed by girls in Kalama?
Yeah, although they didn't know he was here until after he'd come. He and his entourage actually arrived early in the morning.
Okay.
And slept all day and had a huge breakfast.
Okay.
In the evening. And then he came out, and during the day, all the high school kids
mm-hmm.
learned that he was in town and where. And so that's when they kind of mobbed him. But he was very gracious and signed autographs. But what I wanted to do was show just how important this was to the town. So,
yeah.
You know, I've got your lights here. And I just lettered in the background, basically. It happened in Kalama. Because the name of the movie was It Happened at the World's Fair,
mm-hmm.
so echoing that. So anyway, I knew that he had a gold lamé suit that had
mm-hmm.
been designed for him a couple of years earlier.
Okay.
That is perfect. So I found a reference photo on the internet and proceeded to do all the different
all glitz stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
So.
And then, so for your other panel that you worked on.
Yes. I can show you the print of it. Oh, here it is, right here. This is Shirley Loman, who is someone who's lived in Kalama for decades, and she is the vice president of the local women's club.
Okay.
Which is Kalama backwards, Amalak.
Yes. Okay.
And she was described as being everywhere all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So I thought, well, the best way to do that is to fly around. So she has been on all the boards, fundraised all year
mm-hmm.
round, hosted events, and I decided to focus on the flower and book sale that they have annually.
Mm-hmm.
And let's see, it's May, or I think it's in May or early June. So I have her carrying a basket of books, which of course would be impossible for anyone to even walk around with, let alone fly around with, which we like to do that sort of thing, make
yeah.
things ridiculous. You know,
okay.
Like if something's flying in the air, it'll be something that you've never seen before, mm-hmm. and the way it's powered is ridiculously, that wouldn't power anything. Oh, good light. So, if you were to look very closely, you would see I have a book called In the Garden, and there's flower seeds and a trowel. And then over back here, which is a little hard to see on the print, it says, weeds kill. That's all I thought I'd focus. She apparently had a reputation for pulling dandelions and working in the garden, so I thought having dandelions would be fun. And this is the Kalama community building where she had her fundraisers and did lots of stuff.
And then just, I think you might have mentioned it, how did you find out about her to make her the center of this print?
Yeah, we had a list of topics
okay.
put together by very painfully over a long time by
mm-hmm.
Tim Hills, our company historian.
Okay.
And he and Mike McMiniman, they always figure out kind of how do we do the
mm-hmm.
topics, what's the most interesting, what can we find information on.
Yeah.
And it's all about the local people
mm-hmm.
and events in town.
Okay.
And so on that list, I saw her,
yeah.
and there was very little in the way of pictorial references, which I love, because mm-hmm. then I could just kind of make things up.
Yeah.
Very cool. I did have a nice photo of her, and I found a reference photo for the building.